Hey there, my name's Elgin Cook. I have an awesome wife. Her name is Melissa Cook. She's the author of The Call of the Last Frontier. It's a really riveting tale of her 20 years. Well, I was there too, I believe.
Guys, Wyoming Jeepers here. We're heading up for the Pryor Mountains. It's June 18th. It's about noon. It's going to be like 94
here. It's pretty hot right now.
So where are we going, sis?
We are going to go up to see the ice cave and find us a cool cabin. Come along and join us for the ride.
And maybe some wild horses and some
wildlife. Yeah. Montana. Pryors are mainly in Montana, and I am having a jelly donut that I have been dreaming about for weeks. This road is rough. If you have the ability to air down, you will want to do it on this road. And if you don't,
it'll rattle your teeth out.
You can see the road up at the top where we were at, though.
Yeah, we need to do that road when there's no snow.
We do.
I'm filming Dan coming up the hill with Elaine standing in the middle of the road, which I do not blame her one bit.
Need to get up where it's cooler.
Let's just keep heading up where it's cooler so that we can enjoy our lunch.
There's a really good spot off to the right where we've stopped before.
Okay, well, Dan's not remembering for sure, so let us know because that sounds good.
Dan wouldn't have been paying attention. Bam. That kid would have rammed right into us coming up the switchbacks. Yeah, he was going like a bat out of hell.
If you see any weird plants out there and it has three leaves, let it be. Three leaf of three, let it be.
I'm gonna go count how many leaves are over there.
Yeah, you better.
I'm going to right now. Oh my gosh, there's three leaves on it.
But by the looks of it, that's a wild rose.
Then Elaine says, maybe it's the itchy butt stuff.
This plant right here is a wild strawberry.
Where?
Right here. These are wild strawberries.
It's like catching fish. You can't remember every one.
What the heck?
That's what?
You're just full of lies.
To the Big Ice Cave, right? Big Ice Cave. We're gonna hike down in it, and Elaine's gonna put some ice cubes in her drink. I'm gonna hold her to that. She said she was.
Big Ice Cave, Custer National Forest. What are you laughing about?
Says there's bats in the cave too. We've experienced those before.
We're gonna go to the ice caves.
I did scare you, and you know it.
Okay, guys, we're coming up to the fossil wall. If you watch real close, you might be able to find some fossils. And I'm not talking about you and Elgin.
Yeah, we are.
There's a couple of fossils up here.
There's four fossils up here. Ooh, it kind of stinks.
Well, that's the water Elaine wants to get her ice cubes from.
Like it's probably 45 degrees in here.
It's a big egg. Zoom up, Melissa.
Woo! Woo!
There, zoom back there and see.
Woohoo!
This wall is cool. Yeah, it's really cool.
I'd probably make my bed over there so I wouldn't be wet.
This is the ice cave, guys.
If you come here, you want to bring a lot of light.
Yeah. What the heck? Okay, up on the ceiling, Elgin.
Over here, see all the sparkles?
Oh my gosh, look at that.
Look at all those.
Holy cow.
That is nuts, huh, Dad? Do you like how cold it is?
Very cool. No pun intended. That's a lot of stairs. If you come up here, you're gonna have to be prepared for some stairs and hiking. Ooh, look at all the backlit flowers up there. There's not very many stairs. Yeah, there's a lot of stairs.
big old drifts of snow.
And there's a little mud on the road coming up. It's been quite peaceful most of the day, considering what we went through last weekend, the flooding.
4 feet of water in some creek.
Raging through.
Yeah, this is where it all starts.
Yeah. It was quite a weekend last weekend. Lots and lots of water on the Bighorn. So we're in the Pryors.
We just reached the drifts.
Not too bad.
I think Dan's trying to stay out of the mud.
Trying.
Yeah, I keep telling him it's funner in the mud.
Should we try to go through it?
No.
Why?
Because there could be a boulder in there, Dan.
There's not. That's the road.
This is the road. Man, we can't get over that.
But I could have drove right over the top of that.
It didn't even cave in.
Why is it tall?
Because it's wild horses out on the other side. They might could just jump the other ones. I think you just drive through it and it's electric.
I thought you were gonna grab one, Wayne.
Slow at getting out.
The promised cool weather on the mountain has arrived.
Penn's cabin up in the Pryor Mountains. It's a beautiful cabin.
Penn's cabin was built by Perrin Cummins, nicknamed Penn about 1925. When he applied for this homestead patent, Penn didn't have the $8.50 that was required to complete the process. Penn was short.
This is Penn's cabin. That little stove works and everything.
I'm 5 foot, so Penn was short, or they crawled in the cabin. If you had to wait out the weather, this wouldn't be a bad place to do it. Sneaking a donut, I see.
Yep. Good thing we're not related.
You guys are two peas in a pod.
love this little road.
Did you say this is a bumpy road?
Yeah, this is like a real cool road, and it's pretty bumpy.
Yeah, I remember this cool shaped fence.
We're finding seashells in the sandstone.
Which, show me one.
Well, it's, there's one right there. And it shows that this used to be the top, the bottom of the ocean, and now it is the top of the mountain.
Just a little sidetrack.
Look at that hole in the rock.
Are you gonna drone in that?
Holy cow, look at that. Our legs are burning. Oh man, just my thighs are on fire.
My calves.
No, it's not because they're rubbing.
I gotta get a breather, man.
My heart's pounding. That's a steep hike. Thank you.
about you guys, but this road from Penn's Cabin on, I just think is spectacular. I love it.
It is a really cool road. We need to come down it more than just today.
He got his nose to the ground. He's probably looking for a mare.
Exact spot right here where I am at, where that car was halfway off.
There was a car halfway off of this?
Right where you're at, Elaine, right there, they were halfway off.
How in the heck did you help them?
Myron had a winch. Yeah, did you see what it would have been had they gone?
Yeah, that's scary.
How did they get off the road?
Yeah, how did they get off the road?
I have no idea.
Here's a flashback to June of 2015 when my brother and I and our wives were on this same road and we came across this car that was very, very close to having probably a rollover 10 times down the side of this hill.
Whenever you're ready.
Yeah, he's ready to jump from that truck, isn't he? Just in case, keep the door open.
Well, it can't pull that way, so.
Yeah.
The most you could do is flip that back end around, huh?
Yeah, and then.
Well, that could be ugly. I'd keep that wheel turned, man.
Yep, they're lucky people. Husband and wife. He builds artificial legs and limb, or. Prosthetics in Billings.
He almost needed them.
Yeah.
All right, it's in neutral.
All right.
Ready? Ready?
It's moving. Nicely.
Looks good. Uh-oh.
It's straining.
Yeah. Oh, it's coming up. Oh.
Yeah, it's all right, though.
Is it?
Yeah, it's going to do that. It's going to do that.
But it can't come off.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, but I think this tire's kind of going up.
Yeah, it's got that hill.
I'd get out of the way, man.
Go easy.
It looks like it's ready to go.
Maybe we ought to get out of the way.
Just go easy.
Just go a little bit.
Yeah, see, it's already coming down. Nice. We're good, yeah. We're about out. Woo! Nicely done.
Be notified of all new videos and click the bell and set to all.
Here's what happens when you're bored around a campfire. The fire's all down, nothing but glowing coals remaining, some ashes, lining up for the kill, flying the drone over the fire, and look what you get. Oh yes, how fun is that, Melissa? If you want to watch the two flashbacks that were featured in this video, check out On the Edge, the Pryor Mountains, and The Rise of Willet Creek.
Thanks for joining us for the ride.